Hi guys, this is Structures Explained, and in this video we'll be learning about how to read foundation layout plans. Later in the video, we will talk about how reinforcement is represented for isolated footings and rafts by schedules and plans. So do watch the video till the end to get a better idea about building foundations in structural drawings. Before we get into the video, please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. For this video, we are considering a simple four-storied office building with a basement parking. The building is made up of reinforced concrete. The foundation system consists of isolated footing below columns and single shear walls, strip footing below basement walls, and small rafts below core wall. At some locations, there are tie beams which connect the footings together. Let's view the construction drawings for this project. The title block of the drawing shows the information about the project. For this video, let's consider an office building for the client name Billy Merchant and the name of the project as Scranton Business Park. Study for foundation starts from reading general notes. This sheet has information about concrete strength, reinforcement strength, clear covers, waterproofing for foundations, and other precautions if any for casting concrete. For this project, concrete strength for foundation is 35 MPa, reinforcement strength used is 420 MPa, clear cover for elements buried in earth is 50 mm, and waterproofing is provided in the form of membrane. General notes also has the design criteria used for designing the concrete elements, which covers codes used and loading considered. Next we come to the foundation layout sheet, which shows arrangement of foundation with respect to the grids. In some projects, foundation layout is merged with column layout plan as per requirement. In this video, we will see individual sheet which has just foundation layout. The foundation layout for this project is divided into four sheets, as a single sheet will be unreadable. Let's look at part 1 of the layout. First thing to study in the drawing is the notes section. The notes tell us how this drawing is to be read. In this drawing, the first note means that the drawing is to be read together with general notes and general detailing drawings. Second note means that all the pit dimensions should be verified with mechanical and electrical drawings. They can be pits for elevator, oil pits, sump pits. The third note means that the isolated footings are concentric with columns unless noted on drawings. Hence, the center of column matches with center of footing. The fourth note means that the foundation beams are concentric with column centers unless noted otherwise. The last note means that all levels shown in the plan are referenced from 0.00, which is equal to 350.5 MSL, short for mean sea level. For example, if the ground level is at level 0.0, then the footing top as per drawing is 5.45 below ground. The project has isolated footings and raft foundation. Let us look at the raft foundation first. The limits of the raft below the core wall is referenced with grids. Thickness of the raft is stated on the plan itself, which is 450 mm in this case. The top of concrete level is also mentioned above the raft. The basement wall, which retains soil from one side, is having a raft strip. The extents, thickness and concrete level are mentioned on plan. A section is also marked on the wall which has details of the basement wall in the drawing S301. Now let us look at the isolated footings. They are tagged F1, F2 and so on for similar type of footings. Footing dimensions are provided in the plan, but they are not referenced with grids, as note section stated that footings are concentric with columns. Let us go to the schedule and section sheets for foundation. This sheet has typical isolated footing, which is to be referred while studying the schedule. In this schedule, footing types are on the left and details such as dimensions, bottom reinforcement, top of footing level and remarks on the top. The longer length is marked as A and shorter length is marked as B. Thickness of the footing is marked as C. The bottom reinforcement along the longer length is marked 1 and in the shorter length is marked 2. Similar convention is followed for top reinforcement with naming 3 and 4. Generally for isolated footings, reinforcement in both the dimensions are same. For combined footing, they may differ as per design. Let us take one example for footing reinforcement in F1. The bottom reinforcement is 12mm bar spaced at 150mm center to center in both directions. Top reinforcement is not provided as per design. Now let us look at the raft reinforcement, which is generally marked on the plan itself. In this case, the reinforcement mesh of 16mm bar spaced at 200mm is provided in both directions. This mesh is similar for top and bottom face. If additional reinforcement is to be provided, it is represented in the same plan. For example, additional bar of 16mm spaced at 200mm center to center is provided below the wall. The basement wall strip footing is also provided with the same mesh of 12mm bars spaced at 200mm center to center. Different designers adopt different styles of representing a drawing. Final aim of a drawing is to convey the information in a clear way. This video presented a conventional way to show the foundation in a drawing. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, hit that like button and comment below your thoughts or questions regarding the video. More such explainer video will follow, so do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. Also check out our social media pages, links to which are in the description. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.